Frutas Holdings completes its first private placement of 200 million pesos in corporate notes. It said these were issued to qualified individual or institutional buyers with proceeds to be used for capital requirements and general corporate purposes. Still in transactions, Globe Telecom closes out the sale of more towers. It sold Tuesday some 90 more to digital shared infrastructure provider PhilTower. The price tag was at 1.3 billion pesos. Globe says it has closed out 1,000 out of the 1,350 towers to be acquired by PhilTower. In all, it expects 20 billion pesos from the undertaking. Also today, more company earnings, starting with Vista Land. The property developer's net income climbed to 10.3 billion pesos last year, higher by 39% year-on-year. Revenues were also up to 35 billion pesos, mainly on robust growth in its real estate segment. Shang Properties also reporting higher profit in 2023. Net income attributable to shareholders stood at 5.51 billion pesos, while gross revenues were up to 9.81 billion. The main drivers, hotel operations of the famed Shangri-La condominium, Shangri-La Manila condominium unit sales, and better rental and cinema operations. From SP New Energy, its net loss widened to 105 million pesos last year on higher expenses. Income was at 7 million pesos from the 2.3 in the first 6 months of 2022. SPNEC came under new ownership last year after tycoon Manny Pangilinan through MGEM Renewable acquired the firm's controlling stake for 16 billion pesos from Leandro Leviste. As for this news channel's parent firm, ABS-CBN Corporation, it posted revenues of 18.5 billion pesos in 2023. That's as core regular advertising revenue for the year grew 16%, hitting 6.7 billion pesos. This helped offset the 7% decline in consumer sales revenue, mainly due to Sky Cable's lower subscription sales. Net loss before impairment, one-time gain, and taxes amounted to 4.4 billion pesos, lower than 2022's 5.8 billion pesos. But including impairment loss, a significantly smaller one-time gain, and taxes, total net loss stood at 12.8 billion pesos. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department, hopeful for Filipinos seized by Iran, will be freed in a month's time. The four crew members of the MSC Aries were among those captured by the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps as the ship sailed near the Strait of Hormuz. The attack on the MSC Aries was in response to Israel's strike on Iran's consulate in Syria. DFA Undersecretary for Migrant Affairs Eduardo De Vega said Iran is only after the vessel and not the crew. He adds the seafarers remain safe and have been allowed to communicate with their families. The Philippines' merchandise exports surged by 15.7% in February 2024. That translates to $5.9 billion, up from $5.1 billion the previous year. The Trade Department attributes this growth to the robust upturn in the semiconductor industry, which it said grew by nearly 32%. The Philippines' top export markets are the U.S., Hong Kong, China, South Korea, and the Netherlands. The Philippine government is hopeful this growth momentum will be sustained in the coming months.